Once again, we're staying in our units and options.dwg file. Now, I did mention previously in this chapter about our units and about that setting where AutoCAD will automatically scale an object to the settings you have in your current drawing. That's what we're going to take a look at now. Now, you'll remember in the previous video, we looked at our options. We're going to do the same, but we're going to change a particular option setting. So I'm just going to right-click on the mouse, go down to Options on the shortcut menu, and that brings up the Options dialog box. Now, we're going to go to User Preferences, that tab there, and we're going to look at this Insertion Scale setting here. Now, the default settings when the units are set to unitless are millimeters and millimeters. Now, this is where you can tell AutoCAD to scale things up. So what will happen here is you can set things that might be imperial to come into a metric drawing in, say, millimeters. So if my source content unit, where I'm getting the information from, which as you can see is my ins units def source system variable, if I set that to, say, inches, it means I can bring in, let's say, a block of a chair or a table that is in inches into my target drawing here, which I know is in millimeters. It's right here. There's all my millimeter dimensions there. So it's Options, User Preferences, Insertion Scale. Set your source to inches. Set your target, which is your ins units def target system variable, to millimeters. And what will happen is AutoCAD will see that something that is set to unitless, which might be an AutoCAD block, for example, if it's in inches, it'll bring it in and take it into millimeters in your drawing. So if I apply that now, and OK, that setting is now updated in the drawing. OK, it's all ready to go. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to jump over here to View. And that's the View tab on the ribbon. And we're going to look at this Palettes panel. Now, there's a really lovely piece of functionality in AutoCAD that doesn't get used that often, but it's very clever. And it's called Design Center. It's this little icon here. So if I click on Design Center, what'll happen is this is how it looks when you first open it up. So you've got the Folders tab, you've got your Open Drawings tab, which is the Units and Options.dwg. You've also got the History, which at the moment obviously is empty. If I go back to Open Drawings, we can see that we've got blocks there. So if I minimize that, there's the one drawing I've got open. I can expand the list and there's the blocks, etc. there. They also display over here. So at the moment, if I clicked on blocks like so for my open drawing, it'll load up all the blocks that are available in that drawing. Now, we do cover blocks in some of the AutoCAD courses as a deeper dive course in the library as well. So don't forget to check out blocks. Blocks are very useful. So we've got all different types of chairs and bathrooms and things, and you can create geometry for these and save them as a block. Now, I'm going to go back to the Folders tab, because by default, this goes to the AutoCAD sample folder. And if I come down that list a little bit, there's an ENUS, which means English, United States. So if I expand that out a little bit, there's a Design Center subfolder. Expand that out there, and there's loads of different sample drawings that are available as part of your AutoCAD installation. Now, depending on your installation, if you don't have these, talk to your IT department who may have installed your AutoCAD. I'm going to go to the Home Space Planner drawing there. And if I expand that out, you can see I've got blocks, dim styles, layers. If I double click on the blocks there, I've got all these different blocks, and you'll notice they're in inches. Can you see that? The readout is in inches. And I'm going to make sure that I bring that chair into my millimeters metric drawing. So I'm just going to bring Design Center down a little bit. And because I've set up my insert, remember we did inches and millimeters in the options. If I click on this once and then just click and drag, can you see the chair is in context? It would be way smaller if I brought that in, obviously, just in inches, because it would be very small. I'm just going to pop it into that conference room there like that and release. There's my little chair there. You can just see it there. If I zoom in close now and pan across, there's my chair. Can you see it's in context with all the other chairs? Now, if I measure this like so, go back to the Home tab on the ribbon, and I just do a distance across the back of the chair from, say, that end point to that end point, it's 431.8. That's in millimeters. There's no way a chair would be 431.8 inches across on the back unless it was a very, very large chair. I'll just exit the measure command there, like so. So that's this benefit of setting that insert units set of variables in your options. I can go to a drawing here in Design Center, and if all the blocks are in inches, I can drag and drop those inches blocks, but AutoCAD will take them up to millimeters for me. And it's a really nice feature to allow you to convert from one unit setting to another unit setting. If you've got some content that you want to reuse from, say, an Imperial drawing, like the Home Space Planner drawing, into our units and options.dwg file.